canoe it. I'm taking off. In case you can't tell, I'm at Smoke Lake. Heading off for 8 days. See you at Lake of Two Rivers in 8 days. I love you, bye.
I love you, bye. Have fun.
Oh yeah, you too. Stay safe. Hey, I made it across Smoke Lake, and I took my pack across this portage. I'm not sure if it's a portage or a stream. And it goes up pretty much, but it's just short, so no worries. Hey, I made it. I'm on Ragged Lake near the portage to South Porcupine over that-a-way. Kind of dark and dreary and drizzly today, but I made it here much quicker than I thought. I left at 7 and I got here about 10 o'clock. I don't think that's too bad. I'm pretty sure it was 2 years ago I was here with Linda. It was drizzly all morning when I was paddling Smoke Lake. Now the sun, the clouds are breaking up, the sun is coming out. The breeze is kind of chilly, but it's keeping all the bugs away. I couldn't see anybody paddling Smoke Lake, and as I got off the portage into Ragged Lake, there was 6 canoes coming towards me. I figure, okay, all them people leaving, I got the whole lake to myself, and I got this good campsite again. Here I am, I'm all set up. Big fire pit, gorgeous view, got my cooking stove here, and my lazy boy over here all set up with my books, my binoculars. Look like rain, so I got everything plasticized, and I used to have my hammock hanging here last time. But if I can, I'll show you this dead tree. Part of it fell down right over here. So I figured I better not be camped with my hammock here. There's a nice little flat spot up here for a tiny tent, but way up there, that dead part of the tree, not a good place to camp, put my hammock right under it. So I put myself over near where Linda had her tent last time, right there. Works well. Kind of blocking the path to the thunderbox. See the nice little sign there is at this campsite? The thunderbox is back that pathway back there. But it's a swamp getting there. Gonna have to have hip waders or something. It's pretty nasty path. Too much rain lately. Sun's coming out now. Supposed to be nice tomorrow. If there's a dry spell and a fire ban, just tell me to go camping and it's gonna rain. Okay. Taking time to sit down. I got all set up, found a little bit of firewood, had a cup of coffee. Can't wait for my burgers for supper. Veggie burgers, of course. Nice campsite. It's beautiful out here. Can't see anybody at any of the campsites. Tomorrow's Saturday, though. Who knows what happens then? There she goes. Big turtle. There she goes. Swimming away. Oh no, maybe she's coming back. She's not done. She's checking it out. She just laid a bunch of eggs in that mess of dirt right beside my canoe. She's coming back to shore. Don't see her anymore. She's right beside shore in the water. Water's kind of bouncing her around. Quite windy today. I better be careful when I go home my canoe tomorrow. I don't want to disturb that nice nest. Good morning. I'm on my way, almost. Got everything down here by the water. Gonna head off way down there. Not way down. It's not far. But the portage sounds pretty nasty. It's called the Devil's Staircase. I don't know. We'll see. Then I'm gonna paddle Big Porcupine Lake and go up to Little Bonnechere. Spend the night there. I haven't seen anybody, so I'm thinking I got my pick of the sights there too. See you later. Hey, I made it to the portage from Ragged Lake to Big Porcupine Lake. And it's, you can hear this waterfall for a long ways away. Heard it all night at my campsite on Ragged Lake. So this is called the Devil's Staircase. You can't see it from here, but it's all mud and it's all rocks. And it seems most people show the nice parts of portages, so I'm going to show you this nice part about this portage right over here. Look at all this beauty. Tiny wee flowers. Violets. I love this spring moss. Green, green. So I don't think I'm going to give the devil credit on this one because I don't think he's got any flowers. We go. I made it to the portage on Big Porcupine on going over to Bonnechere Lake. Woohoo! It looks fairly dark in there, but it looks fairly flat because that other one was pretty steep. I'm getting ready to load that one on me and take off. Down there's the portage from Big Porcupine to Bonnechere Lake. It's a pretty little lake. Well, I guess it's not too little. There's a campsite straight over on the point there. And there's a really rocky campsite way over there on all those nice big cliffs. And I have a nice peninsula here. Big cedars, really nice. I got all set up, my hammock. Hard to know are the trees strong enough? Are they wide enough apart? Are they too close? It's not always easy to find the right ones. And then you want to have the downside of the tarp, whichever way the wind is and the rain is going to come from, because today was beautiful, but tomorrow it's supposed to rain. So I'm all set up under there for when the rain comes. Got my food bag hanging way back there. I can almost see it. And the thunderbox is way back there. See my swimsuit hanging. I went for a swim. Can't really call it a swim. Jumped in, jumped out real fast because that water's real cold. But look at this. Is this not so cool? I can take it easy for the rest of the evening and head to bed early because I got a long paddle again tomorrow. But it's so beautiful. Yesterday a turtle laid its eggs right beside my canoe on the beach. Today I met a snapper on the portage and a few lying on rocks on my lazy paddle to this site. Beautiful, beautiful day. So many singing birds. Well, I'm sitting here taking it easy for a bit. I did the staircase from Ragged Lake into Big Porcupine, and that was a very steep. You think you're done it, and then it goes up again some more. And it was all mud. Mud slides everywhere. You had to be really careful stepping, and it wasn't nice steps. It had some steps, but they're impossible to take. It was mostly rocks and slippery rocks, and mud all around the slippery rocks. But I made it. Woo! Woo! Gonna have a big portage tomorrow too, but I think it's fairly flat. It's so nice to sit here and the sun is just going down over there somewhere. I met one couple on the portage, and I saw two other canoes pass by here not too long ago. So yesterday I saw nobody. I had my pick of the sights and it was so quiet. But the birds, I heard the catbird was serenading me this morning when I was packing up. What a crazy bird. He can sing every bird song. It's so beautiful. So many birds I heard today. Catch you tomorrow. Good morning. It's a gray day. It's been drizzling all night. I came from that way. Now today I'm heading up the other way. Got everything put away except my tarp. Ew, it's all wet. But I got these snakes that it makes it so much easier to put the tarp away. Whether it's wet or not, it's not going in the bag anyway. I got my big bag ready to go, and I'll talk to you later. I made it to Phipps Lake. It looks pretty cool. It's got two really nice campsites, but it's really hard to see on this dark, drizzly day. That's one campsite. Looks pretty nice. Only two campsites. Here, short portage around a big waterfall. Just gorgeous. Lots of maple trees around here. I bet you it's pretty in the fall. I tried to be quiet coming across. And I still scared away a duck. Pretty nice. Well, it's kind of dark. Don't have much farther to go. Hey, I made it to Pardee Lake. That portage into Pardee Lake was pretty muddy and pretty long. I'm set up the hill here. It's pretty nice. I had trouble finding two trees that were the right size and the right space to put my hammock. And I think it's pretty cool right here. And up the hill is nice big fire pit, nice benches, nice pine floor all over, pine needles. Oh, the portage was long and muddy. I slipped a couple times, ended up on my butt, lying on my backpack like a capsized turtle unable to move. Had to crawl around in mud to get upright again. Look at this beautiful sight though. Big rocks. Really nice. Of course the thunderbox is way, way back in the bush. Way, way back again. Down over that way. It's a muddy portage I came from. I'm staying here two nights. I think the other portage is over that way. That'll be in 2 days. I get to stay here and rest up. It was drizzling all the way here, but look at that clouds. Now look at that sky now. It's lovely. Nice big pines. Hard to find a branch that's just right for the food bag, but I think I got one right there. May not be too high, but it's the best I could do. And I only had to try 5 times this time. Good morning. Beautiful, sunny, clear day. Hope it warms up because it was a little frosty in the night. But it sure is pretty morning. I got my pathetic little fire going on up here. Trying to cook with a fire for once. Save my little cook stove so it lasts. Gotta watch your step around here, I tell you, all the roots and rocks. There we go. Breakfast is coming. Camping in spring might have some drawbacks like bugs, but got all the nice new green growth. Everything's so bright and green, and then you come across a surprise. You got these beautiful flowers. Just beauty everywhere. You just have to go looking. It's just so surprising. Okay, like I said, there's bugs. I gotta wear the bug net. There's those little tiny no-see-ems here. Breeze is blowing away mosquitoes and anything else that might bother me, but I'm sitting here on the rocks. It's really nice. Sun is warm. I'm drying out my shoes. Drying out my shoes from yesterday. Oh my, I had to walk through that mucky portage. It was unbelievable swamp. Last campsite, I scored some new rope. Look at this. But I got everything out here drying because, yep, I fell in the muck. Everything got wet and muddy. I thought those bags were waterproof, but I guess they're not mudproof. Everything lying around everywhere, trying to hang and get dried out. But it sure is a beautiful day today. Wow. I'm just sitting here having my supper. It's jambalaya rice with beans and peppers. Yum, nice and spicy. Today's been hot and cold, hot and cold, chilly and warm. I put my sweatshirt on, took it off every time I take it off because it's got such a tight neck. I rip my nose off, make a mess on my hair. And I'm glad you don't see I have a black eye from the no-see-ums last night. Were driving me insane. I don't know if the black eyelid is because of the bites or because of me swatting myself silly just to get rid of these bugs. They were crazy. And the mud. I sure hope the portage that I have tomorrow and the next day are not as muddy as yesterday. Because I sure should have had a video of that with me lying in the muck on my backpack in the muck. I didn't know how I was going to get up and everything was mucky. It was a mess. So I got my shoes dry and cleaner today. I'm hoping I don't have to clean them again tomorrow. Always an adventure. Beautiful morning. I'm at the end of Pardee Lake and just about ready to head up the path to Harvest Lake. I think it's Harvest. Let's go have a look. I hear the waterfalls that I'm portaging around. Not a very big portage, not even 200 meters, I think. Nope, Harness Lake. Nice path. It's going downhill and it's not far. Woohoo! Okay, I have to take you on a walk on this bit of this portage just to show you the waterfalls. And never seen this on a portage before, but I saw on the map that it crossed the river, but figured it'd just be a couple of planks going across. This is quite a nice part of the path, let me tell you. After the water, the river, you get a bunch of rocks and roots and steep downhill, but downhill is good. And this, look at this, we got a bridge. We got a bridge to cross the river with, so nice. And can you hear it? It's so noisy. Wow, way down there. It's hot today. Look at that. Can't see all the way down. And then the path continues that way, down the hill. Really nice and sunny, hot day today. Look at that beautiful sky. I got delayed. It's already past 10:30, can you believe it? I got delayed because of... Go back and get my canoe now. I got delayed this morning. A family of geese came and visited me with three fuzzy new little goslings. They were eating all along the shoreline down the path to my canoe. So I packed up and they got really close. I got pictures, but then they got closer and closer. So they were 5 feet away from my stove that was cooking with my porridge. Like, how am I gonna get it now? But they finally moved off just as my water came to a boil and I could have my tea and my oatmeal with blueberries. So I got a late start, but I had fun watching the geese. Hey, I made it to Harness Lake really easy and a quick trip, easy portage. And this is a beautiful sight. I'm on the east side of the island, little island, easy takeout, good place to put my canoe, nice little path. And it's not up a huge hill, so that's fun too. I already did that huge hill on the portage the other day. I haven't seen anybody for 3 days. I only saw somebody on my second day. So it's beautiful here. Out that way, there's a really nice point, a rocky point that I went swimming off of. And this tree has the easiest and best branch for hanging the food bag. It only took me one try to get over, even with the wind. Aha, maybe I'm getting better. Nice little campfire, beautiful trees to put up the hammock and tarp. It's supposed to rain tonight, so. Got the tarp a little low, but hopefully I'll keep dry. Dry in my swimsuit. Thunderbox again is way too far back there, but the rest of the campsite is just awesome. Met some mergansers sunning on the rock down that way this morning as I came paddling by. Beautiful, beautiful. This is rocky points. Rocky cliffs across the channel here over there. Looks like a campsite. It could be a campsite for the Highland backpacking trail. There's a few of those sites on this lake. But oh my, it's so pretty with the red pine needles and the green trees and the blue water. That's where I came from. And on the other side, over that away, Just about straight over there is a, I don't have a big paddle to get to the portage, but the portage is gonna be too big tomorrow. Hopefully fairly flat and hopefully not too muddy. Lots of wood piled up here. Beautiful sight. I made it to Head Lake, and guess what? It's raining. I managed to do that big portage, or kilometer long portage, longest one I've done so far. But of course, when I got it done and I thought I was exhausted, I was ready to set off, all ready to sit down in the canoe and have a relaxing paddle tour this nice campsite here. But guess what? It's was thundering. I had to sit under a tree and try to stay dry till the thundering stopped. Then I waited a while. This is not a bad campsite. It's got a little rocky peninsula out that way. Nice pine needle floor, but there's lots of cedars here. And then I put up my tarp quick to stay dry. It's kind of just drizzling now. And I made a fire. Trying to keep warm and trying to dry myself off a little bit. Maybe dry the tarp up a little bit. I don't know. It's gotta rain when I go camping. Rained pretty hard in the canoe while I paddled here. It's a pretty nice campsite though, aren't they all? I can't wait to sit out there in the sun. But it's lightening a little bit, maybe. I'm gonna sit under here for now. Woohoo! Good morning! I love this huge rock that marks the entrance to my campsite. Rocks all along the shoreline here. So pretty. It was clear and sunny, but now these darker clouds are coming. I'm still preparing for rain. Had a good sleep. I was pretty tuckered from that kilometer portage, which is a course with a double carry, 3 kilometers, which doesn't really sound like much when it's a nice walk on a flat path, but it's never a flat path. Well, maybe one or two of the portages are. I'm set up nice and dry under there. Gonna have breakfast out here soon, I hope. I don't wanna have to carry it all under there, but those darker clouds are coming in pretty quick. This campsite's got a big rock here protecting it from some wind. It's getting windier. Way out there's a nice little rocky peninsula point. And over here is a beautiful point, spot for maybe a tent or maybe just to sit on a sunny afternoon and read a book. But it's nice campsite. Enjoying it. Cedars and big pines. Look at that. Isn't that cool? Looks like a pretty lake, but I'm not getting out there today. I'm going to take it easy and I'll be paddling it tomorrow. Well, it's crazy windy today. I saw one canoe struggling out there, but I guess they made it to a campsite. They pulled it up on shore and they're safe now. But the wind is crazy. And then you gotta fight the waves too. Pretty day, sun and clouds. I'm not sure, it might rain again. I'm camping, it might rain again. I'm a little protected with this big rock ridge here, these nice big cedars, but my tarp is still trying to blow away over there. I got everything bolted down with rocks and things. That portage yesterday was long. Wasn't too bad, but I'm exhausted and I'm glad I don't have to paddle anywhere today with that wind. Got a day to recoup. And I don't have far to go on the lake back to tomorrow. I love this big rock. Way down there is the portage that came from yesterday, down that little swampy creek. Tomorrow I gotta head up that shoreline, not far, to the Bonnechere Lake, so I'll be heading down Head Creek till I meet the Madawaska, and then I'll be meeting up with the Lake of Two Rivers. Everything's a nice bright green in the spring. Spring flowers, spring new life. All those three little fuzzball geese that came up on my shore and joined me for breakfast yesterday. I got this nice path. Thunderbox way back there, of course. But it's not too bad a path this time. It's not swampy or anything. And then over this way is a path that goes straight up. Straight up, straight up. I'm glad that's not a portage. It was bad enough the other portages had. But that's quite the steep climb up there. And further over, that away, beside the thunderbox up there on the ridge, is a clear spot. I might have to go for a walk and check it out. Not like I didn't walk enough yesterday. Hey, I got a nice seat. I'm on my life jacket, leaning up against this big old rock here. It's just beautiful. I've had a good time. This is my last full day here. And tomorrow I head down Head Creek, down the Madawaska River, meet Doug at the beach at Lake Two Rivers campsite, where he's camping right now. And he's solo camping. Just sitting here reading. Trying to not get blown away and watching everything so it doesn't get blown away. But I've had a really good time. It's, of course, I've had thunderstorms and hard rain, beautiful sun, and I've tried to go swimming, but I just jumped in twice and I jumped out real fast because the water's still really cold. But I love to swim, so that tells you how cold it is. But it's been a good time. I'll see you out there. Okay, silly me, I climbed up that really steep pathway. It's long and steep, but I made it. And I found some treasures up here. Look at this. These are spectacular. Wow. Dead tree fell over, I guess. Blew over. Look at that. They are spectacular. I'm glad I climbed up here. Wow. There is beauty just everywhere. The Creator is amazing. Up at the top of this cliff, I also found a well-worn path here. At first I thought it was probably animals, but I was following moose tracks all on the portage yesterday, but I'm pretty sure this is the Highland backpacking trail. And I don't know, doing a portage with a big backpack for a part of the time is bad enough. To carry it all the time backpacking, I'd rather be sitting in a canoe. There's that big rock, marks the entrance to this campsite. Way back there you can almost see this river, the little creek going to the big long kilometer portage. This rock is almost as tall as I am. I'm packing up. Well, I can't really pack up tonight. This is my last night. I can't really pack up till the morning because the lighter stuff's supposed to go in the bottom of the pack, which is my sleeping bag, and it can't go in until the morning, so I stuff everything in a pack for tonight in case it rains. There's always in case it rains. It might say there's no rain in the forecast, but it still might rain. So I always make sure everything is tucked neatly underneath me where it'll hopefully keep dry, as long as it doesn't look like the rain's gonna puddle right underneath me. So it might run off the tarp and under the... So then I put a whole whack of rocks and piled stuff on top of the rocks, and then it'll hopefully keep dry. But it sure looks nice out there now. The wind is calming down and the sky is clear blue. Beautiful day, beautiful campsite, beautiful Algonquin Park. Well, I have to apologize. I don't have any sunset pictures for you. I go to bed too early. That's what you get when you go solo camping. You can go to bed when you want. But I did get a couple of good sunrise pictures. This is as close as you're gonna get to a sunset picture. The sun is shining and shimmering on that water. It's just gorgeous and bright. Maybe that means it'll be nice tomorrow. Just did the portage from Head Lake into Head Creek. So I had to come and take pictures of why there's a portage here. It's pretty cool. Let me show you further. Wow! It's noisy in here. Pretty nice. It's amazing how powerful water can be and noisy. Portage number 3, another waterfall, spectacular again, wow. This is a huge boggy area, it's just massive. And I'm at the point where the Head Creek, which I've been following way back there, and it meets Madawaska right here. You can see the current's really strong coming from that way, so it must come from up there somewhere and the trees. Hard to see where there's an opening. You just gotta follow the current. So pretty. I made it to the 5th portage of the day, the last one, and it's only 50 meters. How awesome is that? It's on the mighty Madawaska River. Another waterfall. Fantastic. 13th portage of my trip. I just have to continue down this little portage, which is equipped with another nice little bridge. Back over the Madawaska River. I don't know which way I go. I guess I'll go down the other way. Somewhere is the end of my portage, not too far, it's only 50 meters. I think it's right down. I don't have to cross the bridge. I just go right down over there. I'm telling you, it's not easy to get in and out of the canoe when you're trying to hold on to it to keep it from going over the rapids. Because it's not easy to get out of these onto the portage when the water's trying to suck you over that. I just have to go a little bit down the Madawaska till I get to the Lake of Two Rivers and then I meet Doug on the beach. That'll be nice. Almost done my 8-day canoe trip. I've been bit now. I always get bruises from trying to fight with my backpacks. I'm tired from all the portaging today. And the other hard portages, I had a really steep one. Had a really long one for me anyway, and I had a really muddy one and that tuckered me out worse. So I'm good and tired, but I am a happy camper.
Here on the beach of Lake of Two Rivers, our final destination, our put-in spot, should be coming around that bend very soon. She comes, still fighting that wind, pushing her sideways. It's a battle. An 8-day solo trip. Covered more than 15 kilometers today, 5 portages down Head Creek, Madawaska River from Head Lake to Lake of Two Rivers. She must be exhausted. Hello.
Hello.
Is that you? Congratulations. That must have been a fight. She canoed it.
Canoe it.
Welcome home.